So the next stretch series we're going to do kind of covers the whole body again, like every other one. You will need a foam roller for this one. I suggest having one of the taller ones. This one's 3 feet tall. Just because the last stretch, you really need something longer, and you'll see why. The first stretch we're going to do, like most of these, is the hip flexor. And the way we're going to do this is we're going to lay down on our back with the roller actually right up underneath our butt. So the easiest way is to lay down on your back. You're going to lift your butt up, pull the roller through. Make sure you're more towards the top of the butt, not down to the bottom of the butt. Interlax the hips. Then you're going to pull both legs in, grab one, and extend the other one, and let it relax. You want to feel the stretch right here. You want to, some people, you know, your legs are like this. Let it relax. Let the knee bend. It's okay. If you can, keep the knee straight and keep the knee pulled in here, great. But this is a serious stretch. The other thing that a lot of times people do is they allow their toe to rotate out on the legs down. Try to keep that toe up straight. Then if you want to get a little bit deeper, what you do is you actually use your glute on the leg that's down to try to drive the heel into the ground. It'll help open up the hips there a lot more. Then you're going to hang out here for a minute and you're just going to breathe. When you're ready to switch, don't just do that. Pull both knees in, reset the hips, grab the opposite knee, and extend the other leg out. A little tighter on this side. So a minute on each side there. When you're done, pull them in, put the feet down, and push the roller out. So that's for the hip flexors. Again, a minute on each side there. The next stretch is called the tactical frog. It's a groin stretch. I suggest, I'm not going to use it now, but you might want a pad on the ground for your knees. So the way it works is you start just on your hands and knees, but you want to move your weight over the hands. So you lean forward, then you widen your knees up real, real wide. You want your feet pointed out. We don't want our toes like this. We want our feet pointed out, and then you just want to sit back into that stretch. Make sure you don't arch your back. You want to keep your back flat. You just want to push back and breathe. Hang out there. When you're done, lean forward and then walk your knees in. You're going to do 30 seconds, then relax a second, and you do 30 seconds again on that. That's called the tactical frog. The next stretch is going to be the child's pose with the QL. So a lot of people have done child's pose. We're going to do it in all three positions. The QL is a muscle right here on the low back, and you'll see when we get to it. So child's pose, easy enough. If you can't get your butt down to your heels, that's okay. Do the best you can. The other thing is to help get your butt down, if you need to spread your knees out a little bit wider, that's fine as well. And again, on this one, because of being down on the ground, you might want a pad for your knees. So you just start here, and you sit down, and you reach your arms out, and you breathe right there. Let the muscles relax. You'll get some stretch underneath the armpits here, if you're getting the low back. You're going to breathe there and hold that for 30 seconds. Then from that position, we're going to just from there walk our hands over to one side, and then the hand of the side that is extended, you're going to really reach that arm so you get more stretch down the side. I'll do it on my, my left side here. So I sit back, all right? Then I'm going to walk my hands over towards my right side. Then I'm going to reach my left arm way out there. Really reach, and I'm going to breathe. I'm feeling it down this side really, really well, all the way down. Just sitting there like that, 30 seconds. Then slowly go over to the other side, 30 seconds. If you need to, between each of those three positions, take a second, it's okay. So again, child's pose, basic right there with 30 seconds, then left side 30 seconds, right side 30 seconds. And the last exercise, or stretch, I should say, and the reason why I like the 3 foot roller is a chest stretch. This one you're gonna do for a minute. The way it works is you're actually gonna lay down on the roller with it down your spine. So you lay down. You want your feet wide when you're on this to help with balance. You want your hips right at the bottom. Relax right there. Take your arms up, go out
opposite sides and let the hands rotate back. As you can see, I'm kind of tight. Ultimately, we'd love to have the arms, the forearms, the wrists, everything touching the ground. I can't do that. I have some clients that can. But just here, breathe. You're gonna hang out there for a minute. Let the muscles relax, just let it open up. Take a little nap if you need to. And then when you're done, just roll right on up. So that's the last or the newest stretch series there. So you start out with a hip flexor stretch over the foam roller, then you go to the tactical frog stretch for the groin, then you go on to the child's pose, and then the child's pose QL left and right, and then chest stretch. Enjoy.